Good morning. We are going to study the development of lateral surface of the hexagonal prism. In previous video, we have seen less development. Now, we will see the cutting plane or section plane. When we cut the inner hexagon, we cut inner hexagon, then how we can see the development, that is very, very important. So, before that, we will see some orthogonal projections related to two planes, horizontal, vertical plane. Basically, these are the two planes. If you ask to show any object which is parallel to horizontal plane and vertical perpendicular to the vertical plane, so how we can show? So it is very simple. If you see this object, if you kept here in that way, so this object is parallel to horizontal plane and perpendicular to the vertical. Perpendicular to the vertical plane. So this is very, very important. Again, I am repeating here, two planes, horizontal plane, vertical plane, these two planes are principal plane, these two planes are perpendicular to each other. Now, if anyone is saying that you want to show if the object is parallel to the horizontal plane and perpendicular to the vertical plane. So this object is parallel to horizontal plane and perpendicular to the vertical plane. Now, if you see this object in that way, now here is very, very important. This object is parallel to the vertical plane and perpendicular to the horizontal plane. Parallel to the vertical plane and perpendicular to the horizontal plane. So these two things are very, very important. Now we are not our concentration is not on the profile plane. Here our concentration is on only two planes, and this method is first angle projection method, first angle projection method, first quadrant, where this object is above HP and in front of VP, above HP and in front of VP, where if you see object, if you keep this object in that way, here this object we can say parallel to the horizontal plane, perpendicular to the vertical plane. If you see this object, now this object is horizontal, parallel to the vertical plane and perpendicular to the horizontal plane. Now, we will concentrate, which is very, very important, auxiliary inclined plane. So, this plane is very, very important. Again, here auxiliary inclined plane and auxiliary vertical plane, but we will focus on only auxiliary inclined plane, which is very, very important to our subject concern and exam point of view. So, here, you see here, you are observer. Now, this plane, this object I have kept here. You see that this object is again perpendicular to the vertical plane, but this is inclined to the horizontal plane. How? Because you see here, this angle is very, very important. This angle is very, very important. This angle, you looking here, I think this angle may be 45, 50, 60 degree to the horizontal plane. But very, very important part is that while you are drawing any object, you can see here this angle is looks here in vertical plane. Means you have to draw in vertical plane, but this angle, this projection is inclination in vertical plane, but angle is to the horizontal plane. This angle is horizontal plane. Now this object is basically inclined to the horizontal plane. Is very, very important. Inclined to the horizontal plane and perpendicular to the vertical plane. Now inclination I want to draw. Again, while drawing, this is very, very important. You are observer. In front view, you have to draw in that plane. So this is the cutting plane. This is a cutting plane. So this is my front view. Suppose hexagonal prism is in front of you and I want to cut in that way. So this angle is inclination angle, or this angle is for horizontal plane, but you have to draw in the front. You see here, same concept I want to apply here. Now this angle is actually horizontal plane, this angle, but you have to draw on the above XY line. That's why this cutting plane is looking here. suppose this is a front plane, this is a one rectangle surface of the hexagonal prism, and this is a plane. We are cutting in that plane. So here the question is this hexagonal prism base is on HP, horizontal surface pe hai. Base is on HP, this is a hexagonal prism, and the important part is auxiliary inclined plane, AIP, auxiliary inclined plane with 45 degree to the horizontal plane. Given angle is 45 degree, which is related to the auxiliary inclined plane. Now, base length is given, maybe 20-25 you can take, and this length, height of the hexagonal prism is also given. Okay, just we will focus on the inclination plane. Again, same number I will have A, B, C, D, E, F, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Same number A, B, okay, B, F here, C, E here, D here, then 1 here, 2, 6 here in upper part, 3, 5 in upper part, and 4 here. Again, this is the perimeter of the base surface, perimeter of the base surface. Now, this is the base length. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the base perimeter of the base surface. 6 base surfaces we have got here. So development is okay. Now, cutting plane. Again, the projections of the cutting plane you have to draw here. Cutting plane is mid at the axis. Okay, mid of the axis, or you can say bisect the axis, and angle is 45 degree. So plane is in that way. Again, I have written here A1, A dash, then B dash, F dash, then C dash, E dash, and D dash. These projections we have taken here. Now, here, A dash projections, cutting plane is here from the start. So, A point is here, then B point is here, then C point is here, then D point is here, then again, reverse, you see here E point. Again, E point is here, then F point, basically you see here, F point is here, and then E point is here. So, successfully we completed the development of the lateral surface when the AIP auxiliary inclination plane is given here with 45 degree to the horizontal surface. So, this is the problem for the hexagonal prism.